don't tell anyone, and it's kind of embarrassing for being a 300-pounder, but that little broad, she scares the living bejesus out of me.
Knowing Diana for 15 years now and what an incredibly tough cookie she can be, what I respect about that is her ability to motivate her staff and be in the forefront in the industry. She's a character in a good way, and we love to have her in the industry, and we wouldn't have it any other way. Uptown has a ton of energy. They have a lot of personality. The employees, there's all different age groups that work there, all different cultural backgrounds. It's a very unique place. If you're progressive, there's somebody there that can help you. If you're conservative, there's somebody there that can help you. If you're young or old, there's somebody there that can help you. So she's got a great mix of employees and just a beautiful store and a great location, and that shows. And I think, you know, when you talk to people, I travel the market a lot and I hear people, oh, that woman downtown Chicago, that she does the commercials, that Diana. So everybody knows who she is because of the way she promotes herself and puts herself out there. And she does a phenomenal job. I'd put her at the top of the list with any store out there that was able to promote herself and stay in the forefront in the face of the consumers. She does a great job.
Being a woman in the cigar industry has been an interesting, very big challenge for me. And when I first started, and then I was in it for a while, then I went to the RTDA, it was called the RTDA, the Retail Tobacco Dealers of America, and I started learning a lot of stuff.
Oh gosh, what I've learned from Diana, that's infinitesimal. Boy, I just think if anybody's met Diana, you know Diana. You know, it doesn't take much to get to know her. It doesn't take a lot of experiences being with her to understand the kind of person that she is. And she says what she feels, and you can always get a straight answer from Diana.
You want answers?
You can't handle the truth. Diana is one smoking hot cigar dame.
My proudest moment was in 1990 when they elected me president of the Retail Tobacco Dealers of America, the first woman president. And I nothing's ever been around to beat that, so.
It's kind of peculiar because, you know, most people meet Diana as part of the industry, but I wasn't part of the industry when I first met Diana. I was actually just an average cigar consumer. I was living in New Hampshire, and I kind of became her friend first before I was ever in the business. And in fact, it's kind of weird. I always tell people the first place I ever went to Diana, she actually took me back to her apartment that night. And she showed me all the girl is just a total girl, who am I kidding? But she just, she has all the cigar paraphernalia. Her walls are covered, her bedroom, everything. It's just amazing. And she's one of these just incredibly rich, soulful people that you can't help but to love and you have to admire. And ultimately I have just a deep rooted, unexpressible sense of respect and admiration for Diana as not only as a person in our industry, but as a person who she is. I'm really just honored to know her.
I was fortunate enough to meet Diana in the beginning with Benji Menendez. And Benji being a longtime person in the industry, it was a nice way to get to know Diana in a soft way, because as a rep, she's got the power. And when you bring in somebody that powerful, it makes the blow much softer and gets you a little more respect out of the gate, a little more. And he's a great person, and by having that opportunity to meet her, I think I've just seen what she's done. It's amazing. I mean, she's an incredible woman. You know, fighting again, we've got another smoking ban coming here, another tax issue coming here for the state of Illinois, just the Chicago market. And that's another issue, another hurdle that she's going to have to face in all these years of fighting this industry. And it's amazing that she's able to stay on her feet and be resilient and just do an amazing job and run one of the best shops in the country.
My pet peeve is when somebody comes in the store and they call me ma'am. And that just really sets me off. So then I tried all sorts of things to get them to quit that, but I couldn't quite figured out till one day I figured out that all I had to do was say, well, what's your name, when they were done calling me ma'am. And then I'd introduce them, and then I'd talk to them, and then I'd tell them, call me Diana. You know, and that would end that. They'd get the idea, and then I could be Diana again.
She invited us to a dinner that she had downtown, an event, and at the dinner, she introduced my husband and I, Ken and I, and said, do you know Ken and Julie? They have a cigar store at that time only up in Libertyville. And she said, if you've never been there, you got to go there.
Frankly, my dear, Diana doesn't give a damn.
Uptown is a fantastic store. They have just such a unique look to it. The employees that Diana has working for her are absolutely fabulous people. They help us out when we need something at our stores. You know, we know that we can always call down to Diana's store and say, hey, you know, we don't carry this product. Do you carry it? You know, is there any way we could get it for a special customer? And, you know, they'll take care of us that way, or, you know, help us out in trying to locate something or where to get it. So her store is fantastic and her people are fantastic.
I just really have to love what I'm doing at the time I'm doing it, or I need to quit doing that. And I need to visualize anything we're doing that's going to be new and major. And you can see where things should go, actually, if you sit down and be quiet long enough to do that, or even with people and what jobs they should do and things like that. Never, ever give up and be the very best you can.
So, I don't know if I should talk about this.
That's all right. Okay. Start again. Yeah. How'd you meet Diana?
I met Diana when I was working with Arango. You know what? Let's start this over. I'm sorry.
Okay, I never do this.
Okay, Doug, are you sure those pictures you're taking of me are really good? Or do you have the wrong view? I understand you just started taking pictures.
I don't know.
That's all right.
How many of them are there?
Just three.
Oh, just three.
Is the coat laying right? Am I sitting straight?
You look perfect. We're rolling right now.
You ready?
Okay. So we're good, yeah. Right.
What if I don't like them?
But then you just say something tactful.
Something tactful. So she's telling a room full of her, you know, 200 customers
right,
to go
to our
store.
I want you to
store.
Say that.
Okay.
I like that. And anything else, and I will prompt you, okay?
We were rolling there.
Oh, I screwed it up. Oh. Oh, okay. I'm just going to ask them. Can you guys keep it down, please? Okay.
Look at these shoes.
Not too bad. Those are better.
Definitely.